Today I'm going to have a closer look at printing photos. I get asked on a daily basis, what's the biggest print I can get from my camera? Now you'd think that the higher the megapixel count, the bigger the image that you can print from that camera. Now this is true to a certain extent, but it's not the whole truth. If you do a search for this online, you'll find that there are many charts showing you your effective print size for the resolution of the camera that you have. With a bit of research, you'll also find out that there's a recommended DPI, and this is dots per inch. The dots per inch and resolution of an image are intrinsically linked, but give a drastically different outcome depending on how they're viewed and what they're viewed on. For example, a standard 1920 by 1080 monitor would be fine when you're viewing an image on it with a DPI of 70 to 80. However, when you're printing, the recommended DPI is 300. So I'm going to do a test to see what I can get away with and what looks good. I've printed the same image 6 times at 6x4. From a scaled down version of the edited full size image, you can see it has pushed the DPI up to 1000. Looking at the final printout, it's very crisp and clear. Next, I drop the dots per inch down to 300. This is the recommended DPI for viewing an image at arm's length or less. The resolution on this is now 1800 by 1200. This is also really clear, and I can't tell the difference between this one and the first image I printed. For the third image, I dropped it down to 200 dots per inch at 6x4 inches. This gave me a resolution of 1200 by 800. Again, looking at this image, it was hard to see much difference. Up close, it starts to get a little less sharp, but at arm's length, it's fine. With the fourth image, I set it to 150 dots per inch, and the resolution was 900 by 600. At this DPI, it is starting to get a little less sharp up close, but I think this would be fine in a picture frame on the side or hanging on the wall, as long as you weren't viewing it closer than a meter away. At 100 dots per inch, it does start to get a little bit fuzzy, and at 50 dots per inch, it's unusable and just looks blurry and pixelated at arm's length. So for an A7 III at 300 dots per inch, technically the biggest you should be able to print would be 50 by 33 centimeters. However, I've already printed a photo at 70 by 50 centimeters and it looks great. I think I could actually push this a lot further as well before seeing any degradation in the print quality. And this comes down to viewing distance, which is a really important factor. And it's something you don't actually see when you're looking at printing guides online. Now, if you follow the rules of these printing and resolution charts and you wanted to blow an image up to the size of a billboard at 250 to 300 DPI, you'd end up having to take a 15 to 20 gigapixel image, which is ridiculous. However, billboards aren't meant to be viewed from arm's length away. When you stand further back from a billboard, that's when you start seeing the whole picture. If you could walk up to a billboard, you'd see that the pixels are actually really big. But as you step away, these start to blend together and you just start seeing the whole image. So the further away the person is going to be viewing your image, the bigger that you can print it and the lower the DPI that you can get away with. If you live in an area where there's lots of billboards about, you may have noticed the ad campaigns by Apple and probably by a lot of other smartphone companies. They take advantage of this viewing distance. And then they'll print an image that has been taken on one of their phones. A lot of people will look at these images and think, well, I don't really need a big DSLR or mirrorless camera. I can take really good images with my smartphone, and this ad campaign proves it. However, this is a little bit misleading. As with a billboard, if the viewing distance is 10 meters or more, the DPI can be dropped right down to 15. Now the A7 III produces an image of 6,000 by 4,000 pixels. Now, if you're going to print this onto a billboard and the viewing distance was going to be 10 meters or more, you'd be able to blow this image up to around about 10 by 7 meters. And that is around about 33 by 22 feet. The only way that you're really going to find out what your camera can produce is to actually start printing your images. And this is the idea behind this video. If you're printing an image that's going into a small picture frame or you're going to be viewing it at arm's length or less, this should be around about 250 dots per inch. On a wall with a viewing distance of 2 meters or more, you'd be able to get away with a DPI of 100 to 150. And on a billboard, you can drop it down to 15 dots per inch, and print an image of 10 meters by 7 meters. Another thing I've learned from making this video is the relationship between the DPI and the resolution. For example, if an image has a resolution of 3000 by 2000 pixels and you set the DPI to 300, its size when printing from Photoshop would be 25 by 17 centimeters. But if you set the DPI to 70, it would want to print the image at 108 by 72 centimeters. So in setting the DPI, you're basically telling the computer how many pixels you want to fit into an inch when it prints that image. However, when viewing on a screen, if they're both 3000 by 2000 pixel images, that's what they'll look like. They'll both look identical. So I've learned that these modern cameras with the high megapixel counts and decent lenses can produce really big images. And if they're being viewed from quite a distance, can produce huge images. Now there is a lot more to taking a good picture than DPIs, viewing distances and megapixels. But if you take these into consideration when printing your images, you'll be able to produce a much better, crisper and cleaner image. As always, if you like what you see, give me a thumbs up. If you didn't, give me a thumbs down. And for weekly tutorials, hints and tips in photography and videography, subscribe and turn on notifications. I'll see you in the next one.